This video will be reaction and the discussion of My Hero Academia Season 5, Episode 16. This was a lie. This will be reaction of Episode 15. The reaction is now going to commence. Alright, the Hawks thing is continuing. I'm glad. I hope I cut that out. Wow. Twice. Okay. Alright. Wow. Twice and Hawks, I won't see more of that. Okay. Oh. Hmm. Okay. Hmm. Ooh, that's
okay.
Oh. Okay. Tomura. Tomura Shikara. Bring back the feather. I think he did. Alright. Okay, Hawks, give me more information. I know the next episode is gonna be not manga canon, so that will be interesting. Which is sad, because this is getting super exciting. I kind of would have rather them to give me episode 16 and then this. But anyway. He has super hearing. Hawks is broken. Well, clearly. The question is, are they feeding you false information? That's the worrying thing. Hmm. Okay. Right. You're training them for whatever is about to happen. That's insane. Right. That's insane and bad. You want to use students against... Oh, this one. Right. Oh. Right. Whoa. Okay. Hmm. Right. Of course he would have. Oh. Hmm. That's nice. Right. Oh, this guy's training with Fat Gum. Nice. Okay, so I mean, oh, cheese with top 10. Whoa, top 10 as well. Okay, some of these guys got very nice work studies. Okay. Right, your powers. Right. Hmm. Right, annoyed, very annoyed. Okay. Right. Okay. Right, Deku has a lot. He has a lot of powers. Okay. Very detailed. Oh my goodness. Deku, stop. Isn't Deku actually listening? Right, Deku. Right. Good for you. Not reading. My eyes hurt. Right.
Right.
Okay. Good question. Hmm. Then let's. Right. Not pointless. Okay, this is a flashback episode in a way. I guess you are. Right, All Might. I don't think he's trying. Okay, straightforward. Okay. Right, and they were also remembering stuff. This was an important conversation. Hmm. Right. Hmm. Right. Hmm. Right. Oh. I love that. Age 15. Definitely a flashback episode. Very hard flashback episode. Still, I really enjoy it. Alright. He turned. What do you mean? Yep. Instantly captured. Oh. Oh, those guys caught up before them. Oh, okay, Baku. Oh, he's copying. Hmm. Makes sense. Awesome. I love this. Okay. Right. Okay. You said that. Ooh. Right. Right. Whoa. Whoa, he stopped. That's awesome. I mean, collateral damage, but still. Condense your power. Okay. What about Deku? I love this. I love this. Right. Right. He's eating as well. Right. Oh? Right. Wow, he's seeing that. Mm-hmm. Right. Right, that makes all the sense. That's a great lesson in life as a whole. Mm-hmm. Yeah, All Might. Indeed. Right. Right. Is it bad that they like Endeavor more than All Might? I don't think so. But yes, he said it. Hmm. One thing at a time. Now I get the title. Of pretty much every single reaction that has come out. Yeah, there it is. One thing at a time. Let's be clear, was this a flashback episode? Yes, yes, 100%. 30% at least was flashbacks. Did those flashbacks matter and add to the story? Yes. And also, were they short and then automatically after the flashback we get something new? And were they actually connected to dialogue and self-realization and so on and so forth? Absolutely. And that's how I think flashbacks should be done. But anyway, it was a very enjoyable episode. Still, I really like Endeavor. I said it, I like him more than All Might. I do. It is what it is. Obviously enough, now the current Endeavor, which yeah, makes enough sense. We didn't really spend much time with him the first time we saw him. Regardless though, the conversation that Todoroki had with Endeavor, or rather, what he said about him, the fact that he's just there to use him, makes enough sense. Perfectly acceptable, and I am glad. And I am, obviously enough, happy that Endeavor was hoping that Shoto is trying to accept him a little more. And obviously enough, he's not pushing it, but he is hoping for it. And that's perfectly fine. I don't think Endeavor is wrong in hoping that it can happen. I don't think Endeavor is wrong in even expecting it. And no, wait, I should rephrase that. I don't think Endeavor is wrong in being fooled that it can happen quicker than it probably should. So yeah, I am glad they're not rushing the thing with Todoroki. And I am glad that Endeavor is the way it is. Regardless though, Endeavor is actually an impressive teacher, and he was able to understand Deku, so good work. Props to Endeavor about that. I'm just impressed. I know for a fact that the next episode is not manga canon. My brother hated it, and he said that it's worthless and I shouldn't watch it. But I will watch it. Well, he didn't say I shouldn't watch it, but it was garbage and it didn't matter. And he hates all the characters that are apparently in that episode. So, we'll see. I still kind of want to watch it, and I am gonna watch it. But this episode, I really love that Endeavor gave some specifics to... Yeah, I think that's what I want to say. To Bakugo and Todoroki, and also the very important lesson that is one thing at a time, and at a certain point, that one thing will become automatic. And yeah, that's a very simple and... it's something that makes so much sense. And it is a lesson that, I need to learn still. I really, really need to learn that lesson. Regardless though, it was a great episode. I love seeing the beginning. I almost forgot the start with Hawks because that's how much Endeavor influenced me and inspired me personally. But let's talk about Hawks. As I said, Endeavor, whole thing, love it, makes perfect sense, one thing at a time. Would love to talk more, but the most important thing, technically speaking, is the fact that Endeavor is teaching them so hard precisely because he knows that they're going to be using students in a fight against actual villains. And I think it's kind of confirmed it will be a ginormous amount of villains. He said 100,000, and I think that was just an estimate. It's probably not exactly 100,000, it could be 70. To be honest, even if it was just 10,000, that's insane. If it was just 1,000, it was insane. And also, the Dacus City thing was 50. And that is absolutely insane. And I think that was kind of a test run they did, with probably people that love Destro and are part of the Liberation Army. So yeah, clearly enough, villains, the League of Villains and the Destro Liberation Army, whatever they are working together. And Toga said something interesting, that Tomura is going to be the one that destroys everything. That is kind of dangerous. You see, Tomura's quirk, or Shigaraki, has a lot of potential. He has a lot of potential, especially since we've seen that quirks develop a lot with time, and you can do a lot of creative things that you won't expect with a quirk that doesn't seem that impressive at the start. But yeah. I don't know. I felt like the big threat was the ginormous amount of people that are gonna be helping the Liberation Army and the League of Villains. It's not Tomura that will be the biggest threat, but it could be. Maybe that's actually exactly where Shigaraki wants to get the power of All For One. Because I feel like that's kind of inevitable, isn't it? It does make a lot of sense. After all, he's kind of the main endgame villain for Deku, so I think it makes sense. But then again, he doesn't need All For One in order to be insanely powerful. And obviously if I'm talking about the quirk, not just the person. But yeah, I don't know. There's also the Gigantomachia. That guy is still walking around. We don't know anything about him. I really don't know. We know that the Warp Gate guy has been captured. That is so strange. Yeah, there are some very curious things, and I do love learning more about Hawks' ability, that he has pretty much super hearing, which is what I actually love about my hero, that a quirk that seems super straightforward can have so many different little powers connected to it. So yeah, Hawks definitely deserves the number 2 spot, which, yeah, it's clear that he is definitely going on ahead and making sure that he's going to be deep within the organization. And obviously, you know, he doesn't like it, because he was thinking about maybe just surrounding this whole area, but obviously, you know, that will not allow him to capture absolutely everyone. And he said to Endeavor that he's going to send him a signal, which obviously, you know, led to Endeavor understanding everything, and that's why he actually tried to teach the three main characters so hard. But anyway, the most important thing is the fact that Hawks is definitely a good guy. From what we saw with Hawks in this episode, I believe, 100% believe that he didn't get rid of Giannist. Whatever he did, I don't know. But something else that was confirmed is that he is actually giving those books to absolutely everyone, so that it's not suspicious. And that way he's probably giving them more followers, but getting in their good graces. And also, I don't know. It's a good question. Obviously, you know, the League of Villains and the Liberation Army are trying to use Hawks, and he's abusing the fact that he has super hearing, which this is one of those powers that he should never reveal that he has that ability, and he doesn't need to, obviously enough. But I did kind of express my little worry of the fact that they could be feeding him false information, because they might actually know his super hearing ability, or might be expecting it. I'm really uncertain. But yeah, Hawks is definitely still a good guy, so I'm certain Giannist is fine. We're gonna see what's happening with him later. But yeah, the episode was very cool. It really was. Even though it had a lot of flashbacks, I really enjoyed it. Now, I am very excited for the episode after the next one. But hey, the next one is also probably gonna be fun. There is a video there, you can subscribe to my channel there. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did.